they start hearing about things like this, and you can just see their eyes lighten up. And it's a really, really rewarding experience when you see that. We've recently started doing parole readiness workshops where Natalie and I actually go into the facilities and we talk to large groups of people. Over the summer, we did, I think, 10 workshops at 6 facilities, and we talked to just under 1,100 guys. And talk about what the parole process will look like and what the interview will sound like, and things that they should be getting in line prior to that process beginning. You know, encouraging them to talk about the cases before they go into the interview. The whole criminal justice system, as soon as you're accused of something, everybody tells you don't say anything about it. And when you get to prison, it's not really the sort of environment where you want to talk about your crimes and stuff like that. So, but the last thing we want is for somebody to do 10 or 15 or 30 years and then finally come in front of a parole board, and that is like the first time they're talking about what happened. We know how the parole process works. I went through it. I interviewed, I think, 5 times before I was released. So, you know, we know what the questions are, and we know what the parole board is looking for. And we go in there and we counsel guys. At the end of the day, we want people out of prison. One thing that I that really, really stands out about these workshops is when I start talking about getting out and getting into college, I tell guys about financial aid and the work study program where you can start working. And nobody's really going to ask you about, you know, what's your background. If you qualify for work study, you qualify and you get in. So they start hearing about things like this, and you can just see their eyes lighten up. And it's a really, really rewarding experience when you see that. Because I've been there. I've been at that point where everything is just like, what else can I do? There was too much stuff that I didn't learn, or I didn't finish high school, or whatever. There's too much to overcome for me to go back and get back on that path. And these guys can do it. And we tell them, this is why it's really, really important. If you never got your diploma, you never got your GED out in the world, it's really, really important to do it in here. If you can just get your GED, when you get out, we can help you get into community college out there. And you can get a job, you can start building your resume. You're around a whole different group of people, and you can start doing stuff.